It's so unfortunate. When I'm with our leaders, I talk to them. I'm very close to these youths. These people are very smart. That these guys, forget them, oh, they can rule this country. Oh. They can turn it around within 90 days. My humble self, to the glory of God, I will celebrate the youth of this country today. I will celebrate you tomorrow. And I will celebrate you forever. The president of the country, yes, I respect him as the leader of the nation. But I have much more respect for you than our president. And that's the truth. You can quote me anywhere. Because he has become what he can be. I don't know what you will be in the future. Very successful young guys that are even still in school, in the university. If you see them, you think they are young boys. I'm not joking. But they are in front of their computers 24/7, working. At some point in my life, I said before, I'm 30, I'm going to own a bank. People will laugh. To the glory of God, at 32, I was the majority shareholder in the biggest and the best run mortgage bank in Nigeria. For me, I've made up my mind. I don't want to keep money in the bank today. I don't want to keep assets. I started offloading my assets. And that's the truth. I want to keep what is called wealth in your hands. I keep saying to yourself, any door that is locked, I'm standing on my feet for the entire youth of Nigeria, just for me to show appreciation. And that's the reason why I said, all of you, please sit down.
Thank you. I'm the bunch of skibbers like what Jamaican friends call me, Capella like my South Africans call me, the Coco Master. A cowboy, so dear to you. Killer, you go, killer, you go, killer, fat, you go. No, they don't touch the day. They're about to touch here.
Today, great joy for me. Today, actually, we had another money because we started building it. I wanted it to be a one-on-one event, and that I will come and sit in different tables and rub minds with you, share ideas with you. I'm glad to start. Today I think around 6 o'clock, but nature's call, and I haven't been resting very well for the last 1 week, so I apologize. You are the most sensitive people to me in the world, and I don't like to take for granted at all. Respect for you, and that's the reason why I'm on my feet. Let me just tell you the truth. I'm standing on my feet for the entire youth of Nigeria, just for me to show appreciation, and that's the reason why I said, all of you, please sit down. True appreciation, and to thank you for coming. It's a Monday. We all know that that's the beginning of a new week, and you're always very busy. The truth be told, I enjoy more of your company than anything. Sons, my daughters, and particularly my friends, I can relate to it. I even feel I'm not even much more closer to you. Enough. I think I need to be much more connected to you more. All of you, I want to have a one-on-one. All of you. I know majority of you guys, but it's not even enough. To me, honestly, if I'm with the president of the country, yes, I respect him as the leader of the nation, but I have much more respect for you than our president. And that's the truth. You can quote me anywhere. Because he has become what he can be. I don't know what he will be in the foreseeable future. I don't know. And people will see you are the future leaders. No, you have already become leaders now. You don't know. A lot of you are doing very well. When I read your resume, your profile, blows my mind, honestly. I can mention few names, and a lot of you are still coming up. To the glory of God, I pretty much started early as well in life. Everything about me has been very fast, all the time. Growing up was very tough. The leadership role, God has actually ordained it and designed it. I had a child when I was 19. the glory of God, she is my niece now, Adiola. We were friends. Although we fight a lot now, because she feels she knows more than me. Can you imagine? I think she has read too much. You know, too much of everything is bad. So we have that issue over the last 5 years. So we're just trying to put the whole house in order now. The reason why I'm saying this is, before I became ordinary, I've always been adhered towards the order of the future. Because that time, things were very rough. And my other daughter, she just went inside, she's coming. She's someone I have tremendous respect for. At a very tender age, she's gone through so much in life. God has actually helped her and shaped her life. So I have a lot of testimonials around me. The way Suji said his own story now. The very first time I met Suji, I think about 10 years ago or 9, about that. You know Suji. His logo is when the hype is real. He came, I got a resort and I was managing it. I'm a real estate developer. That was when he started. But he started with a very strong force. And I met him and he was just harassing me. No, this is service is very bad. Suji, can you remember? Your service is, no, you cannot do. It was at my resort with Genevieve and one of Suji's girlfriends. He has always been a very bad boy for a long time. But I'm not going to go there tonight.
Bad boy.
Maybe a typical Yoruba demon, right? Suji, it's about time now. Suji needs to settle down. Enough of all the billions. The billions are starting rolling in now.
Yes.
And it will continue to roll in. I've had very long relationships with a lot of you. Because you started at a very tender age. I am proud of all of you. It's all about money. People, you cannot correlate money and success. Look, for me, I've made up my mind. I don't want to keep money in the bank. I don't want to keep assets. I started offloading my assets. And that's the truth. I want to keep what is called wealth in your hands. So that I will just pick up a phone. I will just say, show him more, my son.
Ambassador.
I need 100 million just to put XYZ in. And the same story with Chiri Aolowo. Chiri, about 10 years ago, there about 10, 9 years ago, Chiri, you know that with his very sexy high balls. Fine boy, she, Yawolowo. He wasn't that popular then, but thank God for his grandfather. So when I met him, he was trying, I think at the same spot, at my resort. Because I had a dream, I used to tell people then that I would be a higher. And I will use that island to celebrate my 40th. I have that preacher when I was 21. I told a lot of people there, you know, there's power in the tongue. Anything you want to become in life, please keep saying it. I'm a living testimony. Honestly, don't bring negative energies around you. Never. Say it, even if you don't have it. Keep saying it. All the time. At some point in my life, I said before, I'm 30, I'm going to own a bank. People will laugh. To the glory of God, at 32. I was the majority shareholder in the biggest and the best run mortgage bank in Nigeria. I used to sit down with the likes of the pioneers of GT Bank, Fola Adeola, Blessed Nagori, at a very tender age. Tyra Day Noku of Blessed Memory now. They were young, in their 20s, when banking proliferation started in the early 90s. Do you know their first dream? They were very good friends. Tyre Adeyemi Noku of Blessed Memory. Fola Adeola is still alive. One of the greatest philosophers in this country. Very deep man. I have tremendous respect for him. They were both in the bank and they said they would. But to the glory of God, something turned around their life. In their late 20s, early 30s, and they floated one of the biggest bank out of the entire Black Race. I have a lot of mentors. Who are you looking up to? Ask yourself every day. Who do you want to mirror your life to be? I've always been looking up to them. As for banking, I didn't do banking. I had brothers that were bankers. But the way they used to, I used to think I would become a banker, not knowing that I would be on the street hustling everywhere. Be a jack of all trades, an entrepreneur, serial entrepreneur. Banks should leave all their non-core banking assets. Opportunity came. And we started looking for money. They split the bank, GT Bank, into different folds. They said, okay, let's split the mortgage banking arm of GT Bank and took it away. I didn't have enough money. I had little, but I was able to coordinate all the pioneers of that. So when there's a will, there's a way. It happened. The same that I mentioned, where I met Shiri Awolowo and Suji Moto. Let me confess to you, they used to bring their girlfriends to these places. Especially Suji. Suji is a very bad boy. Too many girlfriends. But Shehi very well behaved. Shehi is very well. Most of you, you know Shehi now after Big Brother. 2 years ago, right? But I've known Shehi long ago. Very ambitious, very with a lot of power. Great energy. To the glory of God, it happened. I built that island. Everybody thought I was crazy in Lagos. That, how can someone just wake up one day and bring the life to an island 15 minutes away from Ikoyi and Via on a 400 hectare land. Jungle, no life. And to the glory of God, it happened. Not by my might, but by my power. But I believe turning impossibilities to possibilities. Power of imagination. I imagine things a lot in my mind. Till date. Then, on that, my 48th, I prayed and I said, what next? And I said, the greatest call is about to happen. What I am actually born for. The call, and I will drop everything. And people looked at me, they started laughing again. Honestly, I don't know the key thing that came to my mind. And I authored that those words. And to the glory of God, just 2 months after my 40th birthday, the whole thing just started. And that's where I am today. And when God called me to this throne, it's the greatest fulfillment I can ever attain in my life. Every day I'm always thanking God for. I've been looking for this platform because of all of you. And immediately, guess what I did? I walked away from all those things that are ephemeral things, materials of this world. I just walked away. They will call me and call me. I couldn't even hand over and handle the company I built. I'm a real estate developer and a banker, and I did quite a lot of EPC contracts in mining, setting up a lot of industries. So the records are there. I started selling off. I'm not interested again. I just kept selling. But you know what? Anytime I see success, I'm always very happy. And success comes from all of you. I remember to my son, Joel. I can go on and on. Right at the elevator, they were pushing him away. Said, I must meet you. I just had to tell him, why are you pushing him now? Leave him. And he said, I should endorse something for him. And he said, I should pray for him. And I prayed for him. And I said, there's something about you. You are going to be very great. Let's keep in touch. Please, I want to know you more. Today, these are people I call in this palace to sort me out. He owns a bank. He's one of the best brains out of all of you. To the glory of God. One of the greatest innovators. If he goes to China like this, they will give him like 50, 40 soldiers to guide him around. And many of you guys, come on, Yaluki is here. The greatest influencer on Twitter. Selling Okiri in a very innovative manner is my son. A lot of you, I can. Shagari is here. I would love to mention each and every one of you, but I don't want to keep you tonight. But I want us to encourage ourselves more. Right here, some names I cannot even mention. Here, I have very successful young guys that are even still in school, in the university. If you see them, you think they are Yahoo boys. I'm not joking. But they are in front of their computers 24/7, working. I insisted that they must come tonight. Many of them, I need to build a lot of great future around them. Guide them very well. Let them use other people's mistakes to learn. I've made a lot of mistakes in the past. I keep saying it. Any door that is locked, I'm ready to open it. You are not even utilizing me well.
Ah.
Yes!
We make you proud.
This January, this year, I took like about 50 of us on a charter plane to Ghana. We went to Flenjo. She followed me. This doctor, this Ashewo, this Yobagimon. Where is he? He's here. Oh, ha,
ha. Stand up.
He slaughtered three of my daughters within my list. I cannot believe it. It's so unfortunate. When I am with our leaders, I talk to them. I'm very close to these youths. These people are very smart. They drive me even nuts. Me, that I used to be very restless. I, at some point in my life, I used to hug to my age so that I would look old because I'm discussing with very, very highly placed people. I will use that star. But to the glory of God, God has blessed me thus far. I'm so sorry I'm taking your time. I am pleading and appealing. I want to be closer to you. All of you, one on one. In fact, I think Suji, we need to build another palace in Lagos and Abuja.
Yeah.
So that we will bring this kind of initiative closer. What do you think? Suji, the hype must be real. We've started, so we need to expand.
All over Nigeria, all six jokers.
Lucretia, Luciano. It's not only him,
Lorenzo.
In Lagos and Abuja, I have a lot of young guys in their late 20s, early 30s. They are doing exceptionally well. And you are calling them Yahoo Yahoo? If you see them, they look like Yahoo Yahoo. Who like you? Dreads, their jeans, I don't know why. Where is this my boy here? He's around this financial group. Gokala. Where is Gokala? He's gone to sleep. Aha! See, look at him. He has completely locked his head. Come on. He's one of my sons too. I like to call him, I don't want one of the biggest banks. Plenty of you like that. I'm sorry, because of time, I would have loved to mention all your names. I want to celebrate you. I'm closer to our leaders by virtue of my position. I talk to them, oh, that these guys, forget them, oh, they can rule this country, oh, they can turn it around within 90 days. All the problem we're having in this country. This youth, they own this country. Please, let us give them that chance. Okay, we can now go and gather. I hope you are not. Come, because you look like a man now. I hope those girls are not disturbing you too much. You know you complained the last time.
He's trying.
He's managing.
They're rushing me.
They're rushing me. But he has a lot of money. Are they looking at your money or they are looking at your mannerism? Who you are? Both! Take it easy. And a lot of females in your midst, some of them that are, some of you guys that are, those I've not mentioned, a lot of you that I know, the lawyer, these influencers of these answers, although government is fighting them now, I'm trying to support and I'll keep supporting. They call themselves feminists, quote unquote. But don't let us go there. They like to hide their faces. It's okay. I understand. But we're all together. That's all I need to tell you. We are one. Myself, my humble self, to the glory of God, I will celebrate the youth of this country today. I will celebrate you tomorrow. And I will celebrate you forever. I made up my mind that I want to be going out with you people. Honestly.
Thank you, sir.
And I've been doing that. I'll just call on you, a few of you guys, if not because of Corona.
COVID.
I've gone out with a couple of you guys.
Yes, sir.
In your private jets. Not my own. I don't have one. I'm no longer working. But I'm very proud of you. I want to continue to celebrate you from all the four corners of this country. On this note, I came up with this initiative, that Grass to Grace. I'm going to get 50 of this youth together. Meet them. I don't even want to know them. The last award we did, I don't even know the majority of them. Let us select them. And I'm very grateful for Professor Ayobami. Professor Ayobami has been very instrumental. He works out of our London office. I have a London office on your different global outreach. And we came up with the initiative of RAI. And we are making a lot of progress. And the driver of RAI now is Shakari, Bill Shakari. And he's doing very well. Please, a beautiful round of applause for him. Very committed. Where is Professor? You are here. Come now. Come and stand beside me now. Are you not one of the YouTube?
The dog.
Come and stand beside me. He's been very wonderful. And he doesn't live here, he lives in the UK. It's easier to coordinate things all over the world from there. A lot of people don't know that this is my core calling on this trip. That's why I don't joke with you. I don't joke with you at all. In Tobamagba, Yoruba will say Lamaf. So, Prof, he's on sabbatical because of you. He's a lecturer in the university. What's the name of the university in the UK? Afroshare in the UK. Because the activity is so much, he's now on sabbatical so that we can coordinate ourselves better. Just for everybody to be fine. Fingers are not equal. It's not everybody that will, you know, everybody will have to share it. Some of you will be the ones that will do social gathering, help you connect and coordinate those. You know what I mean? Don't let me say it too much. You have different core competences. And some will be like Tony Singh, that I will be shouting on to coordinate for me and you know, do a lot of great things. Tony Singh, stand up here. Eh? A round of applause for him too. Let's try it. I want to just use this opportunity to appreciate them. It's a very hard youth. He's a youth. One of the youth.
My youth,
3G. He's in his late 20s now. He doesn't like me to say it. Am I cutting or increasing? Increasing or reducing? I'm cutting. Hey, Tommy, see, this lady knows you so well now. Oh. Anyway, on the final note, and I'm very serious about it, Suji, I said it, we are more than this, but some of you guys are very busy. Let us work out an arrangement that will have a meeting place in Lagos, Abuja, Port Harcourt. I will come. Anything that you are doing that is very gracious, call me. I will come and celebrate you.
I miss you.
Me, I have followers of youths. I'm always very happy. I celebrate them every day. I can stand like this till daybreak because of you. So on this note, I came up with that initiative. I told him, Professor, stand up now, doctor. Professor, come with you. Professor Ayobami, I told him, I don't want to know them. Go and get the best minds. He said the money is too much. I never forget money. I've never put money forward in my life. Never. Anything I do. Never. Smart money. You know what smart money is? Smart money goes like this. It will naturally find its root. Develop concept first. Then money will follow. So we want to fund and support the initiative of these guys, these young guys. We have a lot of them in all these universities. Lot there. They need helping hands. They need good hands to lift them, just to shield them. A lot of them are helpless. They've harassed them. You understand what I'm saying? And they've done it and gone for good. I mentioned during the NSAR story that I am a victim by virtue of my daughter. She was terribly harassed by those police, this NSAR. And I asked her, what is your problem? Why didn't you tell me? And you know what she told me? That, what are you talking about? What if you are not my father? She never mentioned it to me until after months. And a lot of people like that. So for me, I want to be a shield. I want to be a buckler. I want to let dreams become a reality, because that's the greatest joy that I have. No more. There's nothing I can become again in life. Nothing. This is the second time we're having this gathering that I'm saying to all of you. I'm developing it, having close relationships with all of you on a one-on-one basis. Both male and female. Very happy. I feel fulfilled. Thank you for coming for my 50th coronation anniversary. Today, I am fulfilled. To be in your midst, I am highly fulfilled. God bless you, and God bless all the works of your hands. Thank you for the love. Thank you for your cooperation. May God continue to be with you.
We love you. We love you. We love you. God bless you. We love you.
So I will just tell the G2G millionaires to come out. Just 5 minutes, and then we will go and sleep. Or if you want to rock, as Willie Aruni said,